Hi everyone, this is Kushal Ghosh and today we'll be discussing about 5G cellular networks and we'll also look at some of its advantages. So 5G cellular network or the fifth generation network is the latest advancement in cellular network technology. It is the planned successor to 4G or the fourth generation network which almost all of us use now, and 5G also brings us a lot of advantages. So what will we discuss in this video? We'll get to know what is 5G, what does 5G have to offer us, we'll discuss about the evolution from 1G to 5G, we'll get to know the key concepts of this, we'll get to know the basic architecture of the 5th generation network and look at its advantages, and finally we'll conclude the topic. So what is 5G? 5G or the 5th generation wireless technology is completely wireless. It has almost no limitations. There may be some, but its advantages surpass them. It is a real world wireless technology with real world applications, and it has seemingly fast data transmission speeds. What does 5G have to offer? 5G will come to use worldwide in almost all cellular phones. It has extraordinary data capabilities. It has high connectivity. It gives more power and features to the end user's hand. It has a large phone memory. It will give more dialing speed, more clarity, more precision in audio and video. So how did we evolve from 1G to 5G? First we had 1G, then 2G. Then in the past we were using 3G. Now most of us use 4G, and in the future almost all of us will be using 5G. So what was 1G? 1G was the history of cellular network. It was developed in 1980s and completed in the early 1990s. It was based on an analog system. It had speeds up to 2.4 kbps. It worked on AMPS, that is Advanced Mobile Phone System, which was launched by the US, and it was the 1G mobile system. But it had a disadvantage. It allowed users to make voice calls only within the country. Then we had 2G. It was developed in late 1980s and it was also completed by the late 1990s. Now this was the first generation which was developed on a digital system. 1G was on analog, but from 2G we came to the digital system. The speed was increased by multiple folds. It gave a speed of up to 64 kbps. There were new services such as digital voice and SMS with more clarity. It had semi-global facility, and 2G are the handsets which we use today. They were 2.5G. then which came afterwards, which had a few more capabilities. Then we had 3G. 3G was developed between late 1990s and early 2000s until the present day. We had for the first time transmission speeds up to Mbps. The transmission speeds were from 125 kbps to 2 Mbps. It had superior voice quality, good clarity in video conferencing. It gave new features such as email, surfing, online shopping, banking, games, PDA, information, and global roaming. Then we have 4G, which all of us use now. It was developed in 2010. It is very fast and more reliable than 3G. It had high speed of up to 100 Mbps. It gives high performance, easy roaming, and it is a low-cost service. And this is the future, 5G. Next major of mobile telecommunication and wireless system. It gives 10 times more capacity than others. Expected speed is up to 1 Gbps for the first time in history. It is very fast and more reliable than the 4G networks. And it will also be lower cost than the previous generation. Now let's get to know some key concepts of 5G networking. 5G networking is real wireless world with no more limitations with access and zone issues. It uses IPv6, where a visiting care of mobile IP address is assigned according to location. It works on one unified global standards. It has smart radio. It works with wearable devices. The end user can simultaneously be connected to various wireless access technologies at the same time. And multiple concurrent data transfer path is used for implementing 5G. Now, the basic architecture of 5G. The architecture consists of OWA, OTP, new applications, VoIP, TV, sensors, GPS, mobile management, and a lot of entertainment services. In this architecture, the application layer and presentation layer are clubbed into the single application service. Session layer and the transport layer come in the OTP section, that is Open Transport Protocol. Network becomes into two parts, that is upper network layer and lower network layer. And the data link layer and physical layer are again clubbed into the Open Wireless Architecture, that is OWA. Thus, as we can see, 5G has a cleaner and a more systematic architecture. Now let's get to know the advantages of 5G. 5G gives us an incredible high resolution for all crazy cell phone users such as us. Bidirectional large bandwidth can be seen in 5G. Less traffic problems, 25 Mbps connectivity speed, better and fast solution, as we know 5G. Uploading and downloading speeds are touching the peak. Enhanced and available connectivity just above the world. It gives high quality service based on policy to avoid error. Data bandwidth of 1 Gbps or higher can be seen here. It is globally accessible, more attractive and effective. It supports virtual private networks, that is, privacy is taken care of because privacy of data is very important. It is available at low cost. And it gives seemingly incredible download speeds of up to 10 gigabits per second. Okay, so now let's conclude. 3G, according to me, was operator-centric. 4G was service-centric. Whereas 5G will be end-user-centric. That is, we, the end-users, will be the center of the whole network. We have proposed 5G wireless concept designed as an open platform of different layers, and the new coming technology will be available in the market shortly. It must be at affordable rates, it will be the high peak future, and it will be much more reliable than all the past generation networks that we have seen. Okay, so that is a conclusion. Thank you very much. So guys, if you enjoyed this video, please do press the like button. Thank you.